गुड इवनिंग, दिस इज जितेंद्र पेटकर. आई एम द डेवलपर फॉर दिस प्रोजेक्ट सियोना, विच इज लोकेटेड ऑन बॉम्बे बेंगलोर बायपास हायवे नियर पुनावळे. टुडे आई विल बी गिविंग यू सम इन्साइट्स अबाउट दिस प्रोजेक्ट, सम डिटेल्स अबाउट दिस प्रोजेक्ट एज टू व्हाट इज द लेआउट ऑफ द प्रोजेक्ट, व्हाट इज द स्टेज ऑफ द प्रोजेक्ट, व्हाट आर द व्हेरियस बिझनेस प्रॅक्टिसेस अँड कन्स्ट्रक्शन प्रॅक्टिसेस व्हॉच वी फॉलो हियर, अँड ओवरऑल व्हॉट इज द फिलॉसॉफी ऑफ पेटकर प्रोजेक्ट्स बिहाइंड रनिंग दिस कन्स्ट्रक्शन इंडस्ट्री. नाव कमिंग टू दस लेआउट ऑफ द प्रोजेक्ट, यू कॅन सी हियर दॅट इज द बायपास हायवे विच गोज टुवर्ड्स मुंबई, दॅट इज द एक्सप्रेस वे, अँड वी हॅव दिस ॲक्सेस टू दिस प्रोजेक्ट. करंटली वी हॅड प्रपोज दिस ॲज 15 मीटर्स ॲक्सेस रोड अँड विच विल बी एक्सटेंडेड टू 18 मीटर्स लेटर ऑन, अँड ॲट द एंट्रन्स दॅट नंबर टू वी हॅव अवर सेल्स and engineering office. We have a very state of art offices over here to cater to all the requirements and to provide all kind of services to our esteemed customers. We also have a sample flat and show flat available over here because we allow all our customers to view that flats only, and we don't permit customers to go on the actual sites for safety reasons. At number three, we have that proposed gate for this society. This entire land is around 9 acres, and we have this development. It's a mixed kind of development whereby we have residential development into two phases. This is the phase one, which is comprises of 6 towers, and phase two, which will come up with another 4 towers. So in totality, this project would be around 10 towers, approximately 600 flats. And where we are currently, that offices and sample flats, there we are proposing the essential shopping, which is very important for such kind of development, where around 600, so almost 2,000 people would be staying over here. So for their basic needs, daily needs, they would require some kind of shops and services. And for that purpose, we are providing essential shopping over there. Now, coming to the part which we launched in year 2014, this phase one comprises of 6 towers, all are 14 story. There are two level of parkings, one is at the basement and one is at the ground level, and 14 story residential flats. If you see the layout of these buildings, you would see it is kind of a fan shaped design. The basic purpose of putting these buildings in such a way is to ensure that sufficient light and ventilation is available to each and every flat. As well as these are all non-overlooking flats, so every flat would get better kind of privacy even if they come into the their terraces areas. Another aspect of putting these buildings in such a way that while placing these buildings, we carry out a kind of simulation whereby we see what is the position of sun in various period of the year, and accordingly we see that what is the best position of the buildings, whereby if we place the building in such a way that the flats which are inside those flats will require it will consume less amount of power as regards AC as well as cooling, other features of cooling. So that is the reason we carry out a simulation, and according to that we place the buildings in such a way that it will reduce the power requirements of individual flats. Another aspect of placing these buildings such a way is we had placed the underground water tank exactly at the central core of these three buildings, and that's the reason we had gone on -2 level at that point, where we are providing around 8 to 9 lakh liters of underground water tank, which will have provision for drinking water, domestic water, as well as the fire provision. Now, placing that underground tank at that position gives an advantage that the pump sets which will be provided for to pump the water to all the three buildings will take equal kind of power. If this underground water tank would have been placed somewhere else, then certainly the power requirement for that pump sets would have been anytime higher to as compared to its position and the central core. So certainly it would be a kind of saving to the future society. We had provided open type of car parkings at the periphery. There is substantial open space. As you know that we have to leave 10% of the open space, but here it is slightly higher than that, and we are providing this garden area has been split into three different areas, three zones. and because of the layout of the buildings, and according to the age factors, according to the age groups, we have designed these amenities. So if you see at the entry point, we have that senior citizen area as well as the toddlers area. Then here we have a playground. Many of the projects we see that today, many projects entire area is covered by concrete. So here we never wish to have entire all the area covered by concrete or RCC. What we had done here, that we have specifically purposefully provided a playground where there will be a regular playground, and kids can go there and play. They can play and different kinds of sports over there. Then here at this end, south end, we are proposing the community hall for small functions. Around 200 people can accommodate into this community hall and lawn area. There is a maze garden over here, and there is a half basketball court for teenagers. Then here there is a skating ring, or we can call it as a skating track. Then on this part, this is the main garden area. And this main garden area accommodates a swimming pool, a baby pool. There is a clubhouse which have gymnasium, then which will have a yoga room, which will have a creche, because majority of the customers over here are working IT people, and in many cases both husband wife both are working, so there is a requirement that their kids to keep their kids there, and there is a need to have a creche, so certainly they would be looking for a creche somewhere else. So we thought of providing a creche within the premises, so that would be certainly helpful from their perspective. Then there is a open air theater, there is a meditation area, then lawn area, children's play area is also provided over there. So much of the amenities are spread into this phase one, and we see that we had shared this layout, this amenity layout with our customers, and we had taken their feedbacks as well. And whatever amenities which are left providing into this first phase, we are proposing this to be provided in the phase two. Currently, we are working on the phase 2, and most probably these phase 2 buildings towers would come around 21 storey, and the layout of the buildings will be placed in such a way that we'll get a good chunk of land in center of the central portion of the phase 2, and over there we will be providing left of the amenities like badminton courts, lawn terrace areas, these kind of amenities we are thinking about providing in the phase 2 part. As I mentioned, this was launched in 2014, whereby we committed the possession in year 2018, and we are doing this project. The project progress is going as per the schedule, and we are very much hopeful that this will be delivered on or before 31st March 2018, which is the committed date. So that's all about the project. Hope to see you all. I would like to welcome all of you on our site. Do come and have a look to our sample flat and show flat, and as well as the construction which is going on. And I hope you would like the project, and you would certainly think about having investing into this project. Thank you.